Red versus Blue Season 18 Episode 5 Sideways has officially released, so let me break it down for you. So, Tucker's back. Here he is. His life has apparently taken him to a military facility where he trains recruits. Shatter Squad shows up to save him, and wouldn't you expect, Viper Squad is also there, leading to the entire episode being a fight scene. None of which, by the way, Tucker takes part in. The story continues towards the tail end of the episode when, after narrowly escaping death, Tucker carries East to safety intending to extract, but East ends up stabbing him as it's revealed that she and FaZe are actually the same person. Which I'm still trying to figure out if it makes sense. But Tucker's sword is taken and extracted, but as for Tucker, he's dead? I feel like no matter where they take this, it was a bad decision. Like, on one hand, if he is dead, I don't think that he is, what a lame and sad death. And on the other hand, where he's alive, it just felt like a very amateur and cheap method to try and evoke emotion from the audience. Like, they haven't done a good enough job at making us care about the current characters that we wouldn't have the same reaction if, say, one were to quote-unquote die. So they just brought in an old character which fans have come to love because he sort of earned it, and they quote-unquote kill him just to get that shock factor. Like, no matter what, I think this decision just doesn't make sense and was bad. And to top off the bad, he doesn't even do anything this episode. He doesn't have a single fight. He unsheathes his sword once when he's getting held by FaZe, but he gets thrown to the side and doesn't use it after. I did initially think, like, oh, maybe this is some sort of body double, which is why they didn't have them use the sword, because they can't and it's a fake. But if not for that one moment where he unsheathes his sword for almost no reason whatsoever, it really was him. Despite his very feminine way of moving his body, the mocap is whack. And also, they don't even get how to do the bow chicka bow wows. Like, how do you mess that up? He hits on East, gets punched, says, worth, bow chicka bow wow. That's not a moment for that. It's literally just sexual references and innuendos, and somehow you missed the mark. It's like the only thing they knew about him was, oh, this is his catchphrase. He says it all the time. I mean, he hardly talks. He's sitting in a car quietly for most of the episode. It was, quite frankly, just a huge lackluster disappointment. As for East, as you all know, she's my favorite character of the new bunch, but like I said, I'm trying to figure out if her being an echo hologram makes sense. And correct me if I'm wrong, but it feels like what they've done is made a character who's pretty much a metastable AI and called it an echo hologram. So they've set up East as having been split from FaZe for quite some time, enough to go on her own journey, build up her own reputation, become part of Shatter Squad or whatever. I actually don't know how long she's been on her own. But it's clear that the emotion East had and the emotions FaZe have are different. And I mean, it's probably gonna come into play later, like East is going to reemerge because she cares and has become her own person or whatever. Maybe not, I don't know. But that's kind of what a metastable AI is. Like an artificial intelligence that has emotions and can be considered human because of it. It seems like they just casually introduced this, whether they're aware of it or not. It all depends whether or not her existence came from being an actual part of FaZe. I mean, I know she absorbed her physically, so of course she was a part of her. But to like what extent? Was it like flash cloning of the brain which created her and her memories like the director and Alpha? Or is it like a literal splitting of her being? So East was like 30% and FaZe was the other 70%. Like, was East technically real? And if she was, her personality and feelings and what she'd been through should be mixed back into FaZe. It's still interesting what's happening with East. Or FaZe, I guess. Honestly, I think this episode was pretty disappointing. They brought back Tucker and did nothing with him other than kill him. We gotta see where this goes, but this was probably the weakest episode. It was not that entertaining in terms of the action as well. And the story was definitely not there. But those are just my thoughts. Let me know what you guys thought of it in the comments, and I'll see you in the next episode.